Good evening, everyone. TSB Television proudly presents high school girls basketball. You're looking at Richfield High School, where a huge classic suburban showdown is about to take place. The Richfield Spartans are hosting the Hill Murray Pioneers. It's number one in Class 3A, going up against number two based on the Minnesota Scores poll. Stick around. This conference battle will start shortly. Welcome, everyone. I'm Mike Needon, joined by Jeremy Daves. And we've got a big matchup, big classic suburban implications on the line. Hill Murray undefeated in the conference at 5-0. Richfield at 4-1. You know these two teams are going to bring it.
Yes, you got number one versus number two. You got last year's state runner-up Hill Murray taking on up-and-coming Richfield with Jessica January, sophomore up-and-coming player. I'm anxious to see how she's going to play this game.
Speaking of Jessica January, she is on fire this year as a sophomore, the second leading scorer in the state with 26.8 points per game, only trailing Rebecca Dahlman of Bram. And she's gotten that numbers by scoring a lot. In all but two of her games, she has scored 20 points or more. And Leanne Wise, the Richfield head coach, told me you can attribute those numbers to an increased diversity with her shot selection.
You know, the thing about Hill Murray is that Jessica January has seen a defensive pressure team like Hill Murray, but I'm pretty sure they probably played already, but she's going to have her hands full tonight with this game here, with the up-and-coming defense, the fast-break defense, fast-break offense that Hill Murray plays.
And speaking of Hill Murray, I talked with Erin Herman back at the Breakdown Sports USA Tip-Off Classic. She told me then the Pioneers have a little unfinished business after they lost the state final in a heartbreaking fashion in the final minute to Bunnell St. Margaret's. They have the number two and three scores in the Class of Suburban Conference with Bethany Doolittle and Tessa Sitchi. And they also have the advantage with depth and size. So how does Hill Murray utilize that?
Well, number one, they're a well-disciplined team, number one. Number two, they got all the returners started from last year. And they basically is a really good team who has discipline. And what you said, the two top scorers of the Suburban, but the Classic Suburban Conference.
And let's get to our keys to the game. We'll start with the visiting Hill Murray Pioneers. First, they're going to want to control the tempo. Obviously, you want to do that for any team if you want to win any game of basketball. Rebounding will be huge. Again, they have the advantage in the post with Bethany Doolittle at 6'5 against Breanne Guyton of Richfield at 5'10. Keep an eye on that matchup. And win the transition game. Hill Murray knows Richfield has a quick tempo. They're going to run fast, and they got to keep up. Keys to the game for the Richfield Spartans. Breanne Guyton and Katie Anderson, they must stay out of foul trouble. It's because Richfield does not run a deep lineup. You only see about eight or nine players suit up for each varsity game. And second, they'll want to avoid going to a half-court game because that's Hill Murray's style of play. Again, Richfield likes to move the ball. They like to use January's speed to their advantage. So they want to make sure they stay a full-court game throughout.
You don't want to get in foul trouble if you're Richfield because it's going to be hard for you to go to your bench and say that, knowing that you only play eight players in the team.
Two very different styles going after each other in the first of two matches in the Class of Suburban Conference. Who will win the first round? You got to stick around to find out. The starting five. First, Hill Murray. It's Claire Van Dyke at forward, number 15. Corinne McCallum, number 21 at guard. Tessa Sitchi, number 22 at guard. Morgan Rustad, number 32 at forward. And Bethany Doolittle, number 51 at center. Keep your eyes on Tessa Sitchi and Bethany Doolittle. They're the two-player tandem for Hill Murray. Doolittle heading to the University of Iowa next year. And Iowa doing a great job of recruiting Minnesota high school players.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to keep my eyes on Doolittle because she's a 6'5 center. Look for her to have. I'm looking for her to have a good night tonight.
Starting five for Richfield, Jessica January, number 14 at guard. Breanne Guyton, number 25 at center. Sierra Ford Washington, number 30 at guard. Katie Anderson, number 33, also listed at center. And number 35, Hannah Wise at guard. Jessica January putting up big numbers in just her sophomore year. She has more than doubled her scoring average from this time a year ago.
Yeah, she'll probably be a 2,000 scorer by the time she becomes a senior. What do you think?
And we have a Pam Borton alert. Pam Borton in attendance tonight, but Jessica January has matured to a level that you would expect out of seniors. But as a sophomore, she's doing big things, and it's helped that she's played on this team since seventh grade.
Yeah, we look for her to break numerous records by the time she becomes a senior. Like I said, she'll hobby will hit over 2,000 points by the time she becomes a senior.
And before we continue, we would like to thank GrandStadium.tv for providing a web outlet to webcast these games. If you want to purchase a DVD copy of this game, just visit GrandStadium.tv and click the Purchase DVD link at the top of the page. And if you want to look at our other games from TSB Television, just click Search Archive at the top of Grand Stadium's website as Grand Stadium continues its coverage of the high school sports season.
Yeah, I'm looking at the Class of Suburban standings. You got Hill Murray in first place. You got North St. Paul in second place and Richfield in third place. So it's going to be a pretty good game tonight.
North St. Paul, of course, scoring an upset win over Richfield on their home court back in January. For Richfield, they're in a very tough stretch. They get a home game here. They're second, and then they have to finish up, what, 7 out of 9 games on the road this month. Hill Murray with the first possession.
A lot of road games.
And this is their 4th of 6 games in 2 weeks. They played 3 games last week. They're going to play another 3 this week. They've got a game on Friday and Saturday. Tessa Sitchi.
Oh, there you go. Nice jump shot.
First basket for Hill Murray. And Hill Murray forces the first turnover. With Tessa Sitchi, they've said she can be somewhat inconsistent with scoring, but when she catches a stroke, she can do a lot of big things. Misses a 3, but the rebound and the putback by Rustad. Hill Murray, 14-0, their resume. Well, hang on, Sierra Ford Washington is down court.
She was already down court by the time Sitchi made her shot.
That's McCallum going to Doolittle. Gets around Guyton. That's going to be the big matchup to watch in this game.
Yes, as you see, Hill Murray has a big size advantage.
6'4 against 5'10. Hill Murray's resume includes a big win over Eden Prairie in the Breakdown Sports USA Tip-Off Classic in a game where they were trailing by double digits early.
Oh, that'll help them out by the time session start.
Well, Hill Murray and Eden Prairie are in different classes. They can't play against each other in the state tournament.
Well, I'm looking at resume-wise.
Jump ball, Richfield with the possession arrow.
You know, the high school bubble teams?
Well, everyone qualifies for the playoffs, though. Yeah. This isn't the NCAA tournament. And Eden Prairie didn't have their full roster either. Taylor Ewell was at a soccer event because, of course, she will be playing at the University of Minnesota for soccer next year.
Oh, she's a two-sport player.
And she's a pretty solid basketball player, too. There's Wise going through the lane. Can't finish. Rebound Doolittle.
Doolittle might get like 30 rebounds this game. What do you think?
It depends on how well Hill Murray boxes out. Doolittle with the floater. Guyton finds Wise for 3. Short. Rebound Ford Washington. Feeding inside to Anderson, and she's too strong. Van Dyke with the rebound. She has numbers. Whoa. Loses the handle. Wise picks up the steal.
She looked the other way, and the ball was out of her hands.
How many times have we seen that happen? You take your eye off the ball, and all of a sudden the ball's not with you.
All the time.
Doolittle with the block. Again, Doolittle by far the tallest player in the game for either team at 6'4". Foul's going to go against Anderson. That was our key to the game, or one of them for Richfield. Guyton and Anderson can't get in foul trouble, especially with Richfield's thin roster.
No, you don't want none of the Richfield players to get in foul trouble.
Doolittle inbounding the ball. I asked Lisa Bluter when I covered the Gophers-Hawkeyes game earlier this year, Richfield ball, about why Iowa's been able to get so many Minnesota players and why Bluter continues to recruit here, and she told me Minnesota high school players have a strong work ethic.
And I'll probably agree with her on that.
Good values, good fundamentals.
Not only you got Iowa, you got Wisconsin, you got a
And they picked up a few Minnesota players. Alyssa Carroll from Creighton-Durham Hall, Cassie Rochelle, Tara Steinbauer. Of course, we know about Taylor Hill and Ohio State.
And don't forget Marquette. Marquette has a couple of Minnesota players as well.
Angel Robinson, they're going to get Epi Ojulu next year. Sitchi, right side, too strong. January with the rebound. As many points as January gets, she's not afraid to dish out the ball either.
I mean,
there's that pull-up jumper.
You want that in the point guard to have pass the ball, not just shoot the ball. You can't do everything on the team. I mean, the word is called team. You need to be a team player.
Doolittle.
Oh, nice one.
Couldn't get the pass. And it's intercepted by January, finding an open Anderson. Traveling violation. Took, that was the right call.
She took about four steps there.
It was a little late, but it was the right call. We could see it from here. ...6-2, Hill-Murray over Richfield. Doolittle inside again.
She could be doing that all day this game.
Foul, it's going to go against Van Dyke. No, it goes on Wise. I thought it was going the other way. We're going to have a timeout with 14-13 left in the first half. And we were talking about Doolittle. Aaron Hermy told me yesterday, and there we get a shot of Pat Borton with one of the University of Minnesota staffers. Aaron Herman told me yesterday about Bethany Doolittle. She was thrilled when she found out and decided to go to Iowa because it took a lot of pressure off. When you're a player of her skill set, and many high school players go through this, it can be a pressure cooker situation. And this season, she said Doolittle playing with more confidence, and she has shown that early.
Well, when you know what school you want to go to, you want to sit back, but you know what you're going to be doing next year once you graduate.
Sitchi is fouled. She'll get free throws. Sitchi, the number three scorer in the Classic Suburban Conference, with 17 points a game. Sitchi was mature last year, and if you can believe it, even more mature this year. She finds a way to dominate games even if she doesn't run up the scoreboard.
Well, you mature once every year proceeds. You become an older player, not only in the court, but also in the classroom.
Ford Washington feeds to Anderson. That's too low. Rebound goes to January. There's the pull-up again. No good.
This might be one of her bad games today.
Well, she had a rough start in her first game of the Richfield Holiday Classic, and then she turned on the Jets after that.
Yeah, maybe she's a second-half player.
Well, she can play either half. She scored 20 in the first half over their win over Apple Valley at the Richfield Holiday Classic.
Oh, there she goes.
And that's one way to respond when you can't get points. And January going to the line. And again, just a sign of the maturity we've seen from January this year. She does not let a miss get to her. She stays focused. And if she can't get points, she'll find a way to get steals, assists, any other way to contribute.
Which is also a quick play. I see how she stole the ball and quickly get to the basket.
26.8 points per game. Second in the state behind Rebecca Dahlman. And the thing with January, she dealt with a sprained right ankle for the last few games. That limited her production, but she's still going in. She had a big game against Southwest, scoring 33 points in a 100-51 victory, even though she wasn't 100%. Very tough kid. One of two at the line. Doolittle going left, and we'll get free throws. That's another thing Herman pointed out to me with Doolittle. Last year, she was more hesitant to go on her left side. This year, more confident there.
Yeah, she's probably worked over that over the summer, going to the left side, because, you know, if you want to be a better player, you got to go either side.
Fouls
you also got to develop a good jump shot as well.
Fouls on Wise, her second.
Not to mention free throws as well.
Free throws not going in for either team so far. Ten-three, Pioneers over the Spartans.
Here look like they're playing a half-court zone defense.
That's their style of play, and it's worked to perfection so far. And this was a team that returned most of its scoring from last year. And we're 1 minute away from winning the 2010 Class 3A State Championship.
Yeah, my thing is, how did you give up 5 points in less than 30 seconds? I remember that from last shot. I didn't understand that.
It's a strange sport.
He was up by 5 points.
It's a strange sport in high school, even without a shot clock. I mean, UCLA Gonzaga from 2006. UCLA completed their comeback in part because of a forced steal. And that's exactly how Benilde St. Margaret's beat them. But Hill Murray's not a team that's going to hang their heads too much over stuff like that. Again, unfinished business. Doolittle, that's another thing that stepped up this year, her pull-up shots.
Yeah, you got to have that if you want to go to the next level, especially at Iowa.
You could make a case.
She made a split.
That was Wangerin with the splits. She's not the only player who can do that. Jessica January did the same thing to save a possession when Richfield played Apple Valley. Foul was away from the ball. It's on Rustad, her first. But the Richfield team, very athletic and very flexible.
Hill Murray playing in a 2-3 zone.
They certainly are doing a great job controlling the tempo.
Yeah, Hill Murray is a zone team. They play a lot of zone, which is not bad. Yeah.
Taylor Moore will step in. She plays on the junior varsity team as well. Limited to one half, of course, by high school league rules, but we'll get some minutes there. That's Guyton. Looking for January, and it's intercepted by Van McCallum. Sitchie going to Van Dyke. Left side layup, no good. Rustad to Sitchie. Doolittle called for it and said they kick out. Now Van Dyke gets the bounce. 14-3, Hill Murray over Richfield.
They had to go with that half-court press again. Well, not press, but half-court.
That's exactly what Hill Murray wants to do, but Katie Anderson open on the other end.
The one, three, one, you got three in the middle, you got one playing the rabbit, and you got one in the back.
And if you can clear that three-person layer, you've got a pretty good shot. Sitchie, no good. Rebound Guyton. January with numbers, going left, can't get the bounce. Moore. Five for the rebound and Hill Murray ball.
When you know you got a slow team in Richfield, it's easier to run it on 1-3-1. But you got a really athletic team like to run a lot. You, that 1-3-1, they can easily kill that within no time with the speed that the athletic teams have.
January finally gets her first field goal. All but two of her games this season, she has scored 20 points or more.
Nice steal. Oh, she got fouled.
You're right. It's going to go against Sitchie. Jessica January, the younger sister of Pamela January, who is playing Division I basketball at North Dakota.
Did she play at Richfield too?
Yeah, Pamela played at Richfield. Made the Inner-City All-Star Classic, the event run by Derek Rubin. Kind of the outdoor gym type all-star game.
The and one ball.
The street ball, yes. And one. Street ball, that's what I was looking for. Yeah, it certainly has that kind of feeling. Anderson inside again. That's the second time they fed to her, and that's the second time she scored off that back door.
Yeah, looks like the post players for Hill Murray are just sleeping now. Oh, there you go.
That's and all. Just as you say that, Doolittle wakes up. That's 9 points for Doolittle. She averages 17.6 a game.
You could throw a high pass to her. She can catch it.
She's 6'4". She can catch passes. Others cannot. Hengy missed, but she finds an open McCallum.
Good ball handling there because that ball almost went out of bounds.
And for a team that likes to play half court, they do have some agility. Foul on Ford Washington. We're seeing quite a bit of press from the Pioneers and another Richfield timeout with 9:21 left in the first half.
Yeah, they ran that 1-3-1 press so well. Like I said, you got a team, a slower team of Richfield. They can run that 1-3-1 real well.
Well, that's not the only thing they can run well. Last week, the Hill Murray team prepared and served meals at the Ronald McDonald House in Minneapolis. They thought it was a cool thing to do to make a charitable contribution like that. It's important for them to give back, and Erin Herman said that one of the players told her she felt like a better person. Another group went to Feed My Starving Children. And the coach told me it's a great way to learn about empathy, especially for a school like Hill Murray. It's a private school, so the parents have to pay for their kids to enroll. And it just gives you a sense of some of the blessings those kids and the kids on Richfield and anyone else who gets to play high school basketball have that others may not.
Well, go back to what you're saying. Hill Murray is a private school. I mean, they give back. The thing about Hill Murray is they have a lot of pride and they give back to their community. I mean, they're in the Maplewood area, Maplewood, North St. Paul area. And you're saying they're doing the Ronald McDonald House. That's something they'd like to volunteer to do. There's a lot of volunteering and giving back at Hill Murray.
I don't live too far from the campus, actually, and it's just great to see. The players not only focused on improving their own game, but improving the lives of other people who may not be as fortunate. So props to Hill Murray for making that charitable contribution.
I don't live too far from Hill Murray, and I know Hill Murray very well. I have a friend of mine who's a freshman coach, Marty Mudick, is a freshman coach at Hill Murray. Also an alumnus there, went to Hill Murray, also went to St. Mary's, I'm sorry. And he's now a teacher and a basketball coach. I mean, Hill Murray is a well-disciplined school.
Roman Catholic private school.
The tuition is real high, too.
You want to know what else is high? Their point total. Hengy with the first field goal of the game, or her first field goal. Wise goes down and is fouled. Richfield out of fouls to give, we should note. Hill Murray still with three. But private or public, I'd say whatever school you go to, doesn't really matter if you can make it to college or find a way to improve for the next phase of your life. Be happy with wherever you go.
Yeah, I agree with you on that. You know, I'm a alumnus at Tennessee State University. My alma mater, I will be down there this weekend. Going back to my alma mater and see how things is running, see how things is going.
Officials called it Hill Murray ball and then overruled it, changed it to Richfield ball. After Wise's pass was high, must have touched a Hill Murray player. January again. Still can't get the pull-ups.
Yeah, she is having a bad game right now. None of her shots is falling.
Only one field goal, 3 points for January. 20-9, Hill Murray over Richfield. They're up by 11, but that's not that much. One good run away. We're making it the game again.
But that's what I was saying in the beginning of the game. January has not seen a defense like Hill Murray. So she's going to have her hands full this game.
It's not the first time she's had an in-your-face type defense, though. She faced that against Edina. And that's one reason why Richfield lost to Edina. In fact, they lost two games in a row. North St. Paul and then Edina. And since then, they've corrected things.
Well, she's only a sophomore. Like, if she comes a senior, she's going to be a big threat.
Jump ball, possession arrow favors Hill-Murray. And even some of the greats, like Taylor Hill, dealt with that in her last few years. St. Paul Central ran a pressure defense against her to win the 2008 Class 4A state title. You're going to have a bad game here and there. Even Michael Jordan had his off games. I don't know how many he had, but it's just a matter of responding to them, and January has responded well. And Hill-Murray has responded very well since losing that 3A state tournament last year. Over the back ball on Hill-Murray. And while state tournaments are nice, Aaron Herman told me the players are more focused about getting a college education, getting scholarships, getting acceptance, finding a place to continue their education. Basketball, a supplement.
That's the whole purpose of it. You want to go to college and you want to get your degree. Well, women is different, you know. You got girls that go to college, play ball, go 4 years. You know, I wish guys would have that same mentality, but they go from one. They want the money so bad, they go 1 year and go to the NBA or 2 years go to the NBA.
They're looking at adjusting that with the new CBA coming up, enforcing a rule similar to the NFL where you have to wait 3 years.
I would love that rule. Not only for NBA, for the NCAA, because you'll have more competitive teams. And in the NBA, you have more better players with defense and better skill knowledge.
Since she's fouled, she has 3 points going to the line again. She was one of two her last time out. Foul is on Anderson, her second. So keeping an eye on the foul count with Richfield's post players. Anderson has two. She's going to the bench. Guyton has yet to foul, but again, with Richfield's thin roster and the size disadvantage, they can't afford to get into foul trouble.
You said earlier about the she pushed off there.
Richfield just can't find their targets on passing.
You were saying earlier about the JV rule, you can only play a certain amount of games if you want to play varsity?
You can only play one half of JV ball if you're going to compete in varsity.
So what if you have like a really thin team and your team was in like a serious foul trouble, can they go to their JV players?
If they played one half, they can. If they play two halves, I believe the limit is one half.
Okay.
Doolittle gets 11. And look at that, January kicking out to Wanger, and didn't work, but that's the right idea. January figures they're going to gun for her.
With that speed.
Lestad. That was
Hangy,
I should say.
A little bit too much speed to cost the offensive foul.
Leanne Wise giving a word to Hannah Wise and Jessica January. 6:43 to go in the first. 23-9, Pioneers over Spartans. Classic suburban battle. Richfield 11-2 overall. Hill-Murray 14-0 overall. Wise double teamed. Can't get work off the screen.
Oh, you watch that hand. She's pushing off.
How'd she hang on to that? She almost lost it again. And you wonder if that Hill-Murray pressure defense is starting to get to them.
Yeah, they run that zone pressure so well. Oh, but
Wanger
too soon. Somebody got caught sleeping in the post.
That's the only place Richfield has been able to exploit in the Hill-Murray defense so far. There's Doolittle, not much you can do there. 13 points for the future Iowa Hawkeye. Moore was looking for it. Jump ball, Richfield with the possession arrow.
Yeah, I was saying she would get at least 20 points, 30 rebounds, but she already got 13 points already. I don't know how many rebounds she has.
You have to think Doolittle will be in consideration for the Miss Basketball Award this year. Wise. Oh, she threw in the double coverage.
Whoa.
Hangy in trouble. And Aaron Herman with the timeout call with 5:42 left in the first half. And the reason I mentioned why Doolittle would be in consideration, well, her coach gets a chance to look at all the seniors. Aaron Herman is the head of the Miss Basketball Committee.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that.
I imagine she would have to recuse herself if Doolittle or any other of her players get nominated. But since the Miss Basketball Committee is comprised of mostly coaches, you probably have that situation for most schools. But that committee also includes Willie Taylor, the St. Paul Central head coach. And so in addition to their scouting duties, when they scout opponents, when they coach their team, in addition to all that, they go out and they look at the seniors and they do their best to file the nominations. So it is a tough job.
She also has a little sister, Teresa Doolittle, 6'1", sophomore.
Guyton with the steal, was looking for January, but overthrows her target. McCallum.
Whoa.
Air ball.
She didn't look at the rim too well, did she?
One of the few mistakes for Hill Murray, though. They're up 25-11. And with the way their defense is playing, their offense doesn't have to run on all cylinders right now. Guyton. Losing it.
Whoa, nice slide.
Jump ball, Hill Murray possession. But you look at the passing. Richfield, I don't know if they're rushing it, if they feel pressure. They're just not getting clean passes off.
And Hill Murray's not even pressuring. They have three in the middle, and they got one in the back. And that one that's playing in the back is reading like a free safety.
Wonder if any of them watch B.J. Raji's pick six. Bethany Doolittle.
Don't
pick
Raji.
Six, but she adds two more.
B.J. Raji ran a forever in the 40-yard dash.
Wise double-teamed again. Finds Guyton. Guyton, tough shot, and gets the bank.
Nice back shot.
Doolittle with 15. That field goal gives Guyton her first 2 points. 4:15 left. Doolittle, she gets bumped. Foul before the shot.
It's going to be on the ground.
And Richfield in the penalty, so Doolittle will go to the line for a 1-on-1 situation. The foul is on January. And as you look at Doolittle, I'd be willing to make an argument that Iowa is doing a better job of recruiting in Minnesota than Minnesota is in women's basketball.
I agree with you on that.
When you see who's developed, now obviously you don't know everything or how everything will pan out, but Kasheen Alexander, she's a beast for Iowa. One of two guards to average a double-double last season. Theora Taylor put up some pretty good numbers before she had some ACL issues.
Mm-hmm.
Camille Wallin's done pretty well.
That is the big question here. Why is it that Minnesota players is going to other schools other than Minnesota?
Well, 13-17 showing last year might explain a few things. Wise missed the three. This is Rustad going for Hangey. Overthrows.
Oh, a little bit
Anna.
Too hard on that.
Again, these mistakes muted with that defense of Hill Murray just getting to Richfield.
Well, don't you think with the bad record that Minnesota has?
Look at that. Sitchie with the steal. Finding McCallum, but she can't finish. Sitchie with the rebound, but she stepped on the line.
Going back to what I was saying, you would think with Minnesota's bad record, you would recruit better. I think you would recruit better to get better players to come to Minnesota.
They had the 08 class was touted as the pro class that would help get Minnesota back. Guyton working away around Doolittle. Jukes her and finds the basket. That's Guyton's 4th point. Doolittle, by the way, is already at her scoring average. She has 17 points.
She might have 30 by the time this game is over with.
They're continuing to attack. This time Doolittle can't finish. Rebound. Three. Bullseye.
Ooh.
McCallum.
A nice set shot.
5 points for McCallum. January, left side, too strong. They have to find a way to get her some scoring. 32-15. Hangey out to Sitchie. In and out. Rebound Anderson. January. has the speed. Going to Anderson, Wingeren, in and out. Doolittle with the rebound, and it didn't look like she had to fight too much to get it. Instead, McCallum wants another three. Not this time. Richfield ball.
I thought that would have been Hill Murray's ball.
We don't have a replay, and we also have no review system. But it did look like Richfield touched it last from this vantage point, but we don't have the angle the officials do. They have a 10-second rule. January's got to get the ball off. There we go.
But I guess when you're 6'5 and you're fighting for the ball, you're going to have the last touch of it.
Guyton can't get the mid-range. Sitchie brings it up. Doolittle attacking the left side again and gets the swish.
That was like a Vadi Divac hook shot from like back in the 90s with the Lakers.
And that's something that's going to give her a lot of credibility next year with Iowa, that left side drive. Wise for three. Woo! Oh, Richfield needed that bad.
Did not even touch the iron. It just went in. Nothing but net.
Wise's first field goal, Richfield, they don't get that. Their confidence, I don't know where it goes, but it wasn't looking good. Hangy in trouble. Goes to Doolittle for the pull-up. Holy cow!
Wow.
21 points for Bethany Doolittle. Guyton this time gets the mid-range J.
They're answering.
Hill Murray has left her open a few times as well. I wonder if they'll start respecting that after that field goal. McCallum for three. Wait, bullseye.
Hill Murray's playing his own defense, so somebody's going to be open on his own defense.
McCallum with 8 points. Last minute in the first half. January.
Uh-oh.
Everything going in.
She's starting to warm up.
Both sides. It's not working for Hill Richfield's, though. Not working to Richfield's advantage because they can't trade baskets as they're trailing by 17. But in terms of momentum and confidence, you have to like what you're seeing. But Rustad is there for the response.
Hill Murray is just good all around.
It's a volley of points to end the first half.
Last shot, Richfield.
With no shot clock, you can do that. Richfield will have a lot of work to do to overcome a 19-point deficit as we stand right now. But January, we saw getting another field goal.
Look at the double screen.
Feeding to Wise. And Wise is off target for three. McCallum picks it up, but Hill Murray will have some time to get a shot off. Sitchie.
Oh!
My goodness!
Where did that come from?
From behind the half-court line. Holy cow! Sitchie with 7 points. Hill Murray with an exclamation point. Oh, my.
Where is the instant replay for that?
Oh, we've got it. Only fitting that Hill Murray ends the half with a behind the half court three.
That's crazy. That this was probably the best first half I've ever seen since I've been doing color, this 2010-2011 basketball season.
Well, we have one more half to go. That's the great part of it. We're not done yet, but Richfield with a lot of work to do. They trail by 22.
Only the classic suburban.
44-22. We'll take a break and come back with our first half stats and analysis. Welcome back to Richfield High School as TSB Television continues its coverage of the high school basketball season. We are starting the second half between Hill Murray and Richfield in a half that was all Hill Murray. I'm Mike Beaton here with Jeremy Daves. Let's take a look at that in-game box score. Bethany Doolittle with 21 points, and in that process, she passed the 1,000-point plateau for her career. So Doolittle can add her name to the list of 1,000-point scorers in the state.
Oh, there you go right there.
Corinne McCallum with eight. Tessa Sitchi with seven, including that behind the half court three that shocked everybody. Morgan Rustad with four, and two players have two, Hangey and Van Dyke. Brianne Guyton has six, leading Richfield. Jessica January with just five, struggling to find her shot. Katie Anderson with four, with two backdoor layups. Hannah Wise has the 1-3, and Wangerin has the mid-range J. But the pressure defense from Hill Murray just getting to Richfield in that first half.
Yeah, I'm looking to see what January is going to do in this second half. She needs to have a good second half.
Richfield wearing maroon, Hill Murray wearing white. Again, if you want to order a DVD copy of this, just go online to the purchase DVD link at the top of the page to purchase copies of Grand Stadium events and other events. Anderson will get free throws. We'd like to thank GrandStadium.tv for providing an outlet to webcast these games to you. And if you want to watch any of our other games from TSB Television, from Community Hoops, or from Grand Stadium, just click the Search Archive link at the top of the page. So Anderson going to the line. She averages 7.7 points per game. And I jinxed her. I've been given a gag order at Lynx game since I am a beat reporter over there. I cannot look at the free throw stats of any player when they go to the line.
Why is that?
Because they always miss when I do. Mainly the Lynx. Anderson one of two. Guyton goes down. Hill Murray has numbers, but they decide not to pursue. Going to Doolittle again. 23 points.
Well, she is not stopping.
She has the height advantage, and she is making Richfield
it's hesitant, nervous. It's always hard to cover a 6'5 player when you're 5'10.
But I'm looking at that defense, and Hill Murray hasn't been that aggressive. Just Richfield, I think they're getting nervous about having to play a team like Richfield.
See, my father's a basketball coach, and he always says just get in front of the person who's 6'5 and your tallest player is 5'10. Tell him to get in front of them, and it's easier to stop them. It's not that easy.
Bullseye, Hannah Wise, as she responds to McCallum's three, which was only at the top of the key, not behind the half-court line. Unless we get another one of those threes, I don't think I'm going to be impressed anymore. I'm kidding. No, they all have better shooting skills than I do.
Now they're starting to hit Richfield look like they're starting to double-team Doolittle.
It's not impossible to stop a player with a height advantage, but not if you leave him open. 25 points for Bethany. January open on the left. Well, there's one way to solve your shooting woes.
She went in and out and back in for the shot. What's good about Doolittle is she has no fouls yet.
That's Sitchi. Not this time.
Yeah, Sitchi is... Shots is not falling either.
What she needs to do, she needs to shoot from half court more often.
Half court.
January. And one.
There it is.
She somersaults. She's a very athletic kid. She's also on the track team. Very good over there. We mentioned that win over Apple Valley at the Holiday Classic. She did the splits to save possession. Timeout. Hill Murray. Even though they're up by 21, they know they can't sit back just yet.
Yeah, because once January gets hot, it's going to be difficult.
Well, speaking of January, you mentioned she's dealing with a sprained right ankle, very tough. But in the past, and this is why she missed many shots last year, more than this year, she would drive one on three, but now has added that 15-foot jumper. And well, she's trusting her teammates more, and as a result, her shot selection much better. That's why she's averaging nearly 27.
Well, you know, last year she's a freshman. She was happy to be on varsity, and she wanted to, you know, get some points and be known, and I think, you know, when you're a freshman, you want to be that known person, not exactly put the team on your shoulders, but not to be a ball hog, but you want to have your presence known.
She's played since seventh grade on varsity, though.
Oh, you can play seventh grade in varsity?
You can play seventh grade on in the high school league. Well, you're from Tennessee, so we'll give you a pass. Actually, yes. No, wait, you weren't born in Tennessee. You were from New York?
I was born in New York, raised in Florida. I went to college in Tennessee.
Okay, well, we'll still give you a pass.
Yeah, most other states, you can only play when you're a freshman.
January with 10, so she will continue her double-digit streak, which has lasted every game this year. And Richfield forcing a turnover.
Why did she flinch back? She should have got the ball.
I think Wise held back because she knew it went off a Hill Murray player, so all they had to do was roll out of bounds. You don't have to be flashy. You just have to have a good IQ.
That part I didn't see.
Top of the key, Wise. No. Ford Washington with the rebound. January again. Not this time. Van Dyke with numbers. Driving left. Draws the foul on January. Van Dyke, 8.6 points per game, and she, along with Rustad and Hangy, and pretty much anyone outside of Doolittle and Sitchi, Aaron Herman told me, would be the unsung heroes if you were to look at just the box scores. Those were players you'd miss out on. Van Dyke, this is her first year as a full-time starter, the 6-foot junior forward.
Was she the only junior starter on the team?
I'll have to check that, but she's a very quiet and productive 3-4 player, but she misses both free throws. No, Sitchi's a junior as well.
They're going to have some players coming back next year. Their JV was pretty good. I watched their JV earlier.
January gets the long range to Van Dyke. Backs off. Richfield now down by 18. Still a long way to go. Doolittle, left side again.
That was almost like a pick and roll play.
This is the Bethany Doolittle show. January loses the handle. She had an open three.
Kim Murray had caught a break there.
Wise. No good. Doolittle with the board. 53-33. Hill Murray over Richfield. In a game that could decide who wins the classic suburban title, but I think these schools have bigger aspirations than conference championships. Washington tried to find Anderson, deflected by Hill Murray.
Another break there for Hill Murray. Because if she wasn't knocked, she wasn't there to knock that ball out of bounds, it would have been an easy bucket.
Wise gets it off Rustad to maintain possession. We'd like to remind you our next TSB television broadcast will be on Friday, January 28th. Again, these games are tape delayed, so it will come later than that. But the next game you will see from us is Friday, January 28th, when Highland Park and Como Park do battle in a St. Paul City Conference boys basketball matchup. January, 16-footer is short.
She was way off that shot.
What I've noticed in this game, I've had a chance to watch Richfield for a few games now, January is a volume shooter.
Volume shooter, what do you mean by that?
Richfield ball. Actually, Hill Murray ball. Referees overruled the call. Volume shooter is a player, you know, not necessarily selfish, but a player that's going to take about 20 to 30 shots or a set number of shots per game. Kind of a player that's going to shoot the ball with consistency.
Kind of like a Chris Paul type player.
Yes. Fouls January's third. Renee Montgomery is an example for the Connecticut Sun.
Yeah.
She's a player that will shoot the ball about 20 or 30 times a game. Great player. Sitchi. Short. Gets her own rebound.
Oh!
Holy cow! As she was falling.
That was like a fall down layup. Finger roll.
I know. I figured it out. She sees the camera. She wants some TV time. is coming up with all the tricks today.
Call a big game sitchy.
Jump ball, and Hill Murray with the possession arrow. 13-10 left in the second. Doolittle with 27 points, the game's leading scorer, but Sitchy doing the hard work.
Big game Sitchy is what they call her.
I don't know if they call her that, but you might start a trend. Van Dyke might have something to say about that. I think she's telling you, don't forget about me. She is four. Guyton, going to January, short range, now good. Just struggling today.
Yeah, you said it in the first half. Every good player has one of their bad games.
This might be it for January.
Yep, caught a break there.
Anderson deflects the pass. Doolittle from the left. Not this time. Rustad, no cleanup. Sitchy with the rebound, another offensive possession. Too strong. Van Dyke going to the line.
Where is Richfield at with these rebounds?
Fouls on Wenger in her second. Where's Richfield at? I think Doolittle's covering up a few of them. Well, she's not the only big player for Hill Murray, starting five. Van Dyke 6 feet, Rustad 6 feet, and Sitchy 6 feet. Nobody at Richfield is taller than 5'10".
That's a problem. Oh, picked off.
That's one of them. The passing lanes you can't see as well. Van Dyke makes Richfield pay. We're closing in on mercy rule range. January going to Anderson.
Get it out of here. That's what she said. She didn't even jump.
Bethany Doolittle says, that's my paint.
She said next time she'll jump.
McCallum with 13 and Hannah Wise is going to call timeout with 11:51 left in the second. 62-33 the score.
Well, we've seen the domination of Hill Murray. We see why they're number one in the, not only in the Classic Suburban Conference, but what is their ranking?
They're number one in Class 3A. And again, they beat a very good Eden Prairie team, even if they didn't have their full arsenal.
Yeah, I wanted to see the look to Chris Carr of that loss.
One of two Eden Prairie losses on the season. And speaking of Hill Murray, they take their academic responsibilities just as seriously as their playing responsibilities.
Oh, yes.
Team GPA last year, 3.65. Aaron Herman told me she expects Hill Murray will get about the same. She said there was actually a couple bad practices last week, but it was because they were focused on finals. And so she said as long as it didn't carry over, which it hasn't, she has no problem with the Hill Murray Pioneers taking academics and giving that priority over basketball.
Yeah, I know Hill Murray High School very well, and they take academics real seriously. They do not play when it comes to academics.
Wangerin draws the foul. Fouls on Doolittle, her first.
Well, every private school takes academics real seriously. I mean, it's a private school. I mean, you don't have time to be messing around,
but you don't
paying
have time
all
to
that
mess
money.
Around. You don't have time to mess around, period.
Yeah. But every student is not like that.
Whatever,
especially in public school.
Whatever system you're in, public or private, you're going on someone else's pocket. You can't fool around.
Yeah. The school budget is what they call it.
Richfield just can't run the ball like they want to. January draws a foul.
Wow, her first foul.
That's
first foul.
That's her second, actually.
Second? Oh.
But when you're up by 29, I really wouldn't be worried about getting in the penalty here. Wise trying to get around her defender. She does. But Richfield can't drive inside. And that defense keeping them from doing much outside.
Whoa, another foul. That didn't look like a foul there.
And just like that, Bethany Doolittle goes from no fouls to three fouls.
It looked like Richfield is finding their way.
For the first 36 minutes, or 24 minutes of this game, Doolittle had no fouls. Now she has three, and she's going to have to step out for the first time in the game. Lestab will take her place. Keep an eye.
It still doesn't help massage-wise. You got three players with six feet.
Keep an eye on the absence of Doolittle, though. Richfield might have a chance. Wise makes both free throws. January with the steal by herself. You know she's going to make that layup. That gives her 14. I haven't seen a 29-point deficit overcome, but I've only called basketball for 5 years. The first game I called, though, Wise with a foul.
Well, they keep fouling like that.
Third.
They keep fouling like that. You better hope they don't make their own. Well, they're not on the foul line yet, so.
Neither team in the penalty. The very first game I called, Central Street back in 2006 when St. Paul Central had that undefeated 32-0 team. Central was up by 25. Creighton got as close as 8. Couldn't get any closer. But Willie Taylor had a word with me after that game. Jokingly, of course. Van Dyke with the run around the picket fence. She has 7. And Wise gets the push. Call on Hill Murray. That's Hill Murray's last to give. The foul is on Rustad, her second. But Hill Murray will now be in the penalty for the remainder of the game. Something I imagine Richfield will look to exploit. Guyton. A lot of traffic, and she traveled.
Yeah, she traveled there.
Just having a hard.
Sometimes you just got to go straight up with it. If you get fouled, you get fouled.
Having a hard time finding holes in Hill Murray's zone defense. Hill Murray, not having any difficulty finding holes. Van Dyke with 11. January's foul.
Wow.
And Sitchie's going, oh my gosh, she can't believe the call. But in basketball, the calls the officials make are the calls everyone has to live with. And once again, we're not down there.
And now Doolittle comes back in the game. When you're up by 30, you might as well just play your second and third unit. Rest your starters. Because if Doolittle gets in foul trouble, what's going to happen in the last?
You're still up by 28. It would take a lot for Richfield. And even with Doolittle out for the one-minute stretch, Richfield still having a tough time penetrating the zone defense.
They're going to pick and roll.
And Doolittle's bumped by Guyton. That's her first personal.
Yeah, Hill Murray plays a real good pick and roll. I like how she, like how Doolittle pick and roll off the screen.
Count it. Van Dyke with the basket.
A well executed play. $38.68.
If Hill Murray can get up to a 35-point margin, we are past the point where the mercy rule would go into effect and they'd use a running clock. That wouldn't affect the game all that much. But something to keep in mind. Taylor Moore, she's open, and she gets her first field goal of the game. Doolittle. Oh,
there you go. Bow. Off the bank. Doolittle has 29.
Her average is 17.6.
She might have double that by the time this game's over with.
And with a game like this, they have a second match in this series.
It'll be tougher to play at Hill Murray, trust me.
And I was going to say, this might give Hill Murray the edge as the 3A favorite, although De La Salle's not far behind. They've done well despite...
I'm pretty sure they're going to see each other again in sections.
They saw each other last year, actually, in the state tournament.
Well, it might be the state tournament. It might be in sections. It's going to come a time when Hill's going to see De La Salle.
They can't see each other in both. McCallum for three.
There's going to be one of the two.
Well, it would be in the state tournament. They're in separate sections.
Okay.
Hill Murray beat De La Salle.
Unless
last year.
Unless something magically happens that they don't meet each other in state finals.
Hill Murray sending in their reserves, at least some of them. Dana Savino is going in. Actually, they're keeping most of the starting five out. Now we're in mercy rule range.
Mercy rule's here.
Richfield would have to cut the margin to within 30 to stop the clock now. Wise with the layup, and I think Hill Murray's going to back off a bit on defense here.
Well, I guess you have to when you're up by 35.
Well, you don't necessarily have to.
I thought you can't press when you're up by.
There's no rule against it. Oh. It's just not smiled upon. That's all. January for three. Bullseye. 76-45 the score. Richfield getting some baskets here.
January with 18.
And if you looked at that, you'd say, well, January had a decent game, but you look at all the shots she has taken and how many times Hill Murray has disrupted her, and even just shots that have not gone in, even when January has a good look. Would it have changed the outcome of this game? Not likely.
No, not really. That hook shot, she loves that hook shot. 31 for Doolittle.
She can hook, she can go left. What can't she do? If she shoots a three, I'm out of here.
That might be the next trend. Looked like a sub pass to herself.
Microcosm of the game for Richfield. And once again, we are in running time with the mercy rule in effect. It's been in place for a couple years now. Some coaches are split about it. But the more games I've covered, especially at multi-game events, when you have like the Breakdown Sports Tip-Off Classic, when you have holiday tournaments, the mercy rule keeps things on schedule. Doolittle again from the paint.
You think she hit 40?
If she wanted to, I bet you she could. I'm not sure if she's going to out of respect for her opponents. But Richfield, they're not
Get it out of here.
I'll give you one guess on who the player of the game is going to be for Hill Murray.
I wonder who.
Tony Gear says me. I would need a sex change and a few other strange things to happen. If I'm the player of the game.
What was that?
She just did a cartwheel. Two-pointer for Hengi.
What did she
did a somersault. She did a cartwheel. She did the splits the last time we were here.
She's acrobatic, huh?
I'd like to know what she does in the offseason. Good point here.
She better be playing summer league ball.
You think? And give credit to Richfield. They know this game is out of reach, but they're not giving up, doing anything they can, deflecting passes, things like that. And Richfield, they're going to go back to the drawing board. They're going to learn what they need to do to play against a team like this. Tessa Sitchi, I believe that gives her double digits.
16, 14, one of those points.
They don't have her numbers on the scoreboard, but she's had a quiet game. But the game like Doolittle's having, that's Doolittle's fourth, but it's a moot point now. And as you see Richfield, they're not going to give up on their teammates. They know there's still half a season left. And again, conference titles are nice, but these teams have bigger aspirations in mind.
Yeah, you still got February and the first week of March.
Bench players are getting ready to come in. And Doolittle is stepping out. I don't think we will see here for the remainder of the game, but
no
a phenomenal game.
Points.
Yeah, I'm sorry, no 40 points. I know that's going to be so disappointing. Wise with 12. In the game for Hill Murray is Caitlin Langer. She's a 6'2 sophomore post.
Well, you know Hill Murray's going to have size for a while.
And that's the one downside of the mercy rule. Players like Langer and Christy Atkinson who's stepping in, they may not get as much playing time. But, you know, the game is decided. It's out of reach.
Well, we get to see Doolittle's sister come in the game, Teresa Doolittle.
It's a rule I can live with. I guess I'm neutral about it, but I can understand why they put it in. So Hill Murray will stay undefeated. Richfield will fall to 4-2 in the conference, 11-3 in the season. Hill Murray will go to 6-0 in the conference, 15-0 on the season. And again, this will likely place them as a favorite to win the Class 3A title, but again, they've got a tough De La Salle team in Class 3A, and you've got a tough Benilde St. Margaret's team, even though they've lost a couple games. The 3A field, far from decided. January picks up her 20th, and so she'll continue that streak going. Again, all but two of her games, she has scored 20 points or more.
Yeah, like I said, she's going to be breaking records as her career goes by the next couple years. Her high school career.
Her average will drop a bit, but she still has 2 years left, like you said. Very mature. If Richfield, if they can get some size to that roster, get a bigger post, I have to think that will open up more doors for January. But even now, she's shown a lot of things that will make her a phenomenal junior and senior.
Yeah, one thing, Richfield is going to have guards. Watched the JV game earlier. They had a good guard playing. So they're going to have guards.
And that's the first step to creating a good team, getting those guards, that backbone set. Richfield will run out the clock. Wise will shoot off one more. 84-49, Hill Murray dominating from the opening tip. They will stay undefeated in the conference and overall. Just a well-played game by the Pioneers.
Yeah, especially that first half. It was so much intense going on in the first half, and the buzzer beater. The second half, Hill Murray just came out dominating like they did in the first half for a big blowout, 84-49, Hill Murray.
So we'll take a quick break and try to get players of the game from both teams for you. So stick around. Mike Peden here with Hill Murray's players of the game, including Bethany Doolittle, who scored her 1,000th career point tonight and led all players in scoring tonight with 31 points at the last time I counted. Yeah. You have dominated inside and out tonight, and Hill Murray just dominated from the get-go. What was the strategy going in?
I think this is like one of our most important games of the season, and I think we just wanted to come in and do the best we could and kind of get out there and play our hardest right away, and we did that and ended up winning.
Describe the significance of getting 1,000 points. I know a lot of players get to that plateau. Not everyone does. But what does that mean for you to know you got that accomplishment before you retired the green and white and put on the black and gold?
I think it's really important just to, it's just kind of really fun milestone, I guess, just to know that you can get that far and help out your teammates with all the points. And it's just fun, I guess.
Before the game, Coach Aaron Herman told me this team, very poised, very calm group of players. They always focus one game at a time. What is the chemistry, what is the atmosphere that you sense with the Hill Murray Pioneers?
I think we're all just such good friends, and we all hang out, and there's no real drama on our team, and so I think that's what helps us kind of sync and mesh as a team really well on the court.
Well, if there's any drama, it might be who can shoot the farthest. Tessa didn't score a lot of points tonight, but you certainly won in style points. Not only did you get a half-court three to end the first half, you got a layup as you were falling down.
Yeah, I mean, we practiced those, but it was just one of those things where I was just going for it. It was just 2 seconds left, and I was like, I'm going to go for it. I honestly didn't think it was going to go in, but it did. So I was lucky.
I was going to say, do you practice layups while you're falling to the floor?
No, I mean, that was just one of those things. I just got lucky. It just went in.
And maybe mention those situations. You said you got lucky, and so did you just throw it up? And maybe is that a part of the training that Hill Murray does in practice?
We mostly focus on like defense and stuff. We sometimes do like trick shots, like end of the game plays. But we don't really practice that. It's just one of those things. You just keep your eye on the basket and hope it goes in. Yeah.
And keeping an eye is something you've been doing all game. Throughout the game, you were dominant on defense, and you were able to get Richfield to agitate, make them look hesitant even when you weren't pressuring them.
Yeah, I mean, we have a couple really good presses, and we figured out which ones would work for us this game, and we used those to our benefit, and they threw the ball away, and we took advantage of that. So
another thing Aaron Hermey told me about the Hill Murray Pioneers, they're a very charitable team. They always do a lot of giving. You recently worked at the Ronald McDonald House, did some volunteer work there, did some additional work. And what does it mean to make those charitable contributions to give back to the community that has helped support you all these years?
I love it. It's like it's kind of helped part of our school too. We all have to do some service, and I love just going out there and seeing what we can do for other people. And I love, like, when they come to our games, I can feel what they like put out as energy, and I like to go out and give them back.
Yeah, I mean, I feel the same way. Like, going to the Ronald McDonald House was a really fun experience because we've been given so much, and we felt like it was necessary for us to give back to people who don't have as much, and that's what we do at our school, too.
And last question, is there anyone you want to say hi to that might be watching on television or on Grand Stadium?
I guess all of my family, and my parents would probably watch this later, and my grandparents out in Connecticut.
Yeah. I mean, my family's here, but my sister's not. Hello, Rochelle.
You forgot Lisa Bluter, your future head coach.
Yes, Lisa Bluter.
Well, thanks for taking the time to speak with us, and good luck. Who knows? We might see you later on in March.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Tessa Sitchie and Bethany Doolittle of Hill Murray. That does it from here. Hill Murray wins 84-49. For everyone here at TSB Television, I'm Mike Peden. Thank you for watching.